Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Kneon. I'm not here with Geeky Sparkles in this video. We're going to be talking about the Good Times cartoon reboot of the classic 70s sitcom. And it's not going very well for them. Let's just put it that way. I didn't even get that this was supposed to be a reboot of the Good Times show from the 70s. Which, for those of you who don't know, it was actually the character of Florida Evans, who was Maude, you know, Golden Girls, B. Arthur, Maude, part of the Norman Lear-verse, I guess, that it started with All in the Family, and then All in the Family actually spun off, like, several sitcoms. It's kind of crazy when you think about it. It was like All in the Family and the Jeffersons, because George Jefferson was on All in the Family all the time. And then, you know, we had the character Maude, and then Maude spun off Good Times. But yeah, so, you know, the show was, as I gather, it was pretty popular. It was on for a while. And I used to watch Good Times and All in the Family and Sanford and Sons and What's Happening and all these shows on TBS when I was a kid. And you're talking about a nerdy white kid from the suburbs. And I used to like these shows. I watched them pretty much every day. I did. I mean, they were on. They had like a block of comedies. You know, the Evans family, they were always portrayed. I don't know how you want it. They're just normal people, right? It was never like they're just normal people that just happen to be poor. You know, I mean, that was basically it. But they had good times, even though they're poor and dynamite, you know. And this reboot looks vicious and cynical. And I when I first saw it, I never made the connection because everybody looks so different. You know, I never made the connection that this was supposed to be the same family. It was supposed to be the same series. And this one's got Seth MacFarlane in it. So people are complaining that, you know, the white guys don't. I don't understand. So somebody explain this to me. Why is it problematic? Why is it problematic for a white guy to voice Cleveland when it could probably be argued that Cleveland is a lot more respectful to black folks than this reboot? I'm just putting it out there. Like, I would love an answer to that because this just looks, it looks mean. Everything I've seen that it looks mean and stereotypical, and it basically just kind of undermines what the show is all about. And people are pissed. Especially black folks. I think most people are just kind of ignoring it exists. But like, again, this is one of those things where it's like, why the hell would you think this is a good idea? So we're going to talk about it. We're going to cover it mostly because it's animation. And it's an animated series. It's got Seth MacFarlane involved. Again, I don't know how you go from Cleveland to this, but, you know, whatever. Before you get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. Mostly black folks talking about it. Mostly black folks angry about it. I don't think they think it's funny. I mean, again, you've got, you know, this show, I don't know, like, culturally what it meant to people, but, you know, it was a fun show back in the day. It did deal with, like, all Norman Lear shows dealt with pretty weighty topics, but it did it in such a way that seldom felt ham-fisted. And everything that everybody talks about now, you know, dealing with diversity and inclusion issues and social justice and all that, Norman Lear, they did it better back then, you know, than they do it now. We're talking 40 years ago, but case in point. So let's go out and see. People actually have a petition to boycott it. And apparently some of these surviving cast members are not real happy with it. This has come from NPR a couple days ago. Netflix's Good Times, an explicit revival which feels calculated to offend. With an opening image that reads Good Times Black Again. What? It's, again, this is done by Seth MacFarlane, Family Guy, and I think Steph Curry is involved. I don't know. It's packed with the kind of stereotypical characters and imagery which seems sure to anger fans of the original series, which was a groundbreaking 70s-era sitcom. Revered for the way it challenged presumptions about poor black family scratching and surviving in a Chicago housing project. It was a fun show. They seem like a solid family. You know what I'm saying? Like, why would you do that? Why would you turn into the freaking, like, cartoon version of the Bundys, you know? Described by Netflix as a spiritual sequel The animated Good Times features the fourth generation. Okay, so it's, oh shit, it's a sequel. The animated Good Times features the fourth generation of the original series Evans family living in a Chicago housing project still 40 years later. Okay. Yeah, they're not moving on up like the Jeffersons, I guess. This new show opens with the patriarch, a not-too-smart cabbie named Reggie Evans, singing part of the original Good Times theme in a duet with a cockroach. Beverly Evans can tell when her baby is around because her breasts lactate and leak through her shirt. The baby has been kicked out of the house because he's a pistol-packing drug dealer with studs in his ears. And when his... Holy shit. And when his militant older sister decides to go on a hunger strike and protest, she gets emaciated and has flies swarming around her face like a child suffering in an African famine. Oh my God. This is like progressive Seth MacFarlane, right? This is, yeah. Holy shit, dude. You could have done another season of The Orville. You could have done another season of The Orville, but you did this instead. Oh my God. What? Netflix's divisive Good Times reboot is a reminder to watch this 12-year-old TV show with 100% Rotten Tomatoes. Okay. This isn't Good Times. This is another show. This is Black Dynamite. Yeah, I don't know what Good Times is getting. People aren't real happy about it. That was coming from Screen Rant. This is coming from The Root. Netflix's Good Times reboot is flaming, stereotype-ridden trash. Its white creators are to blame. How? Everyone was expecting the worst from the show's trailer. Somehow even worse than that. Wow. Yeah, so they go into the history of the show, and they go into, there was some behind-the-scenes drama. And, you know, I was just like, God, why would you think this is okay? This is another article from The Root. Black Twitter is not done shaming Netflix's animated Good Times reboot. Here we have Candace here says, I got together with my friends, I guess, for this live blog about Netflix's cursed Good Times reboot, which feels like it resulted from an AI search of stereotypical black shit. I can only get through two episodes. I can never get back. Time I can never get back. Wow. That girl Hollinger says, I just realized the drug dealing baby on the new Good Times monstrosity is supposed to be Michael. Michael of all people. What? Another person commented how Dolvin, I guess that's the baby, has presentation as inappropriate, writing on X, yo, that Good Times cartoon is fucking awful. There are ways to lean into our more innocuous stereotypes and still be funny, but a fucking baby doing a pump, a baby formula and starting to twerk. Starting to tweak is not one of those things. It probably twerks too. Holy shit. Huge point of contention is the series uses the name Good Times, but doesn't honor the spirit of the original series. I'm back, but the original Good Times was about poor black family fighting against the statistics. They were keeping their family and their morals intact despite their environment. This goes so far against that they really should have called it anything else. I did not get, when I saw the trailer, I never made the connection, even though it was called Good Times, I never made the connection that it was connect, probably because it's a cartoon too, but I never made the connection that it was supposed to, you know, be a reboot or a reimagining of it. People said some of the voice acting is not too bad. Some people are enjoying it, but it's like, wow. I don't know. I mean, maybe they just wanted the controversy, but there's a petition to boycott it already. Some of the cast members, they don't like it. They said less than welcoming sentiment is shared by Bernadette Stanis, who played Thelma on the original. I did not know it was going to be the way it is. I thought it was going to be different. She said after sharing, she voiced a small part on the Netflix version. I guess they figured if you put us in there, it wouldn't look so bad or whatever. John Amos, who played one of the original's leading characters, James Evans Sr., opted to remain neutral. I can't form an opinion. I haven't seen it yet. Norman and the entire casting company set the bar pretty high in the 70s. They'll have a hard time reaching that level of entertainment and education. I wish them the best. Good luck with that. Good luck with that, basically. He's probably just watching what he says. I don't know. It looks like a shit show to me, but people are not happy. I have no intention of watching it. If you've seen it, what do you think? Is it good? I don't know. I can think of about 9,000 other things that I could be watching instead of this show. It just looks very mean-spirited to me. I'm going to wrap it up. Please subscribe. We'll talk later.